Hello everyone, in physics classes today we are going to start the new chapter of class 12, that is fourth chapter, and the name of chapter is moving charges and magnetism. In this chapter we are going to discuss about the magnetism, but not due to the magnet. In your junior classes you have learned something about the magnetism, that was all about due to magnet. But here we are going to discuss magnetism due to moving charges. And we know moving charges creates current. Current is what? Flow of charges. So we are going to discuss magnetism due to the current. We can also say magnetic effect of current. Means if through a circuit current is flowing, then near about it magnetic field is present. What is magnetic field? A space, a region in which magnetic influences can be experienced, like around a magnet. Suppose I have a bar magnet and around it if I sparkle those iron fillings, iron needles, small pieces of iron, then they are going to reorient themselves in a well-managed arrangement. So this is what? This is the identification of presence of magnetic field. Space around a magnet in which its effect can be experienced. The same thing is for the current. Here we are going to discuss that how the current is going to produce the magnetic field. In very early stages, like in the century 1802, few scientists work on this concept ki wherever the current is flowing, a magnetic field is there. But those theories, those statements were overlooked. Then finally, in 1820, Oersted done an experiment, and that was means the proof, yes, wherever the current is flowing, there is some magnetic field present. So he proved this thing. This one I have drawn the experimental arrangement done by the Oersted, and his experiment was considered very, a fruitful experiment. After that, this was considered ki yes, current is also a source of, or moving charges is also a source of magnetic field. So let's discuss firstly the arrangement of the Oersted experiment. He took a simple conducting wire and he connected with a source of EMF, a cell or a battery. Here is the key. Again, and here he placed on a stand a magnetic needle. What is a magnetic needle? That is a needle which is going to move under the effect of magnetic field only. That needle works in the magnetic field. So near this wire he placed a magnetic needle on a stand. This is also a same diagram. The only difference is the direction of cell is reversed, and if the direction of cell is reversed, the direction of current is also reversed. Okay, the direction of current is from positive electrode of the cell towards the negative electrode. So current is flowing in this direction, anti-clockwise. And in this loop, current is flowing clockwise. The only difference is this. And he placed the magnetic needle. So when he switched on the key, what did he observe? Initially, when key was the off, current was not flowing through the wire and the magnetic needle was oriented in the normal position. When we switched on the key and current starts flowing through this conducting wire, it was observed that this north pole of the magnetic needle deviated or reoriented itself into the west direction. It rotated itself towards the west direction. Magnetic needle's north pole, this end, this tries to rotate itself in the west direction. If I draw the direction, this one is south, this one is north, then this one will be west and this one will be east. So needle shifted towards the west. And in this experiment, when the direction of cell was reversed, so the direction of current is reversed. Here it was observed that the north pole of the magnetic needle was deviated towards the east. That magnetic needle's north pole was deviated towards the east. And we know magnetic needle can deviate or can reorient its position only in the presence of magnetic field. When keys were open, no current was flowing, the magnetic needle was stationary in the normal position. As soon as the current started flow through the loop, the needle deviates from its position. In this condition, the north pole of the needle is deviated towards the west, and in this condition, when the direction of current was reversed, north pole was deviated towards the east. So they are saying ki when current is present, magnetic needle is deviating, reorienting its position. This is the proof, yes, there is some magnetic field, because magnetic needle is working, it is disturbing, and it happens only when magnetic field is present. So this was the proof of the Oersted's ki wherever the current is flowing. This was the second proof, you can say. Initially when current was flowing, needle deviated. But when he reversed the direction of current, the deviation of the needle was also reversed. Firstly, it was deviated in the west. Now it is deviating into the east. These two different things are saying that the direction of flow of current is also important. That is also going to deviate the north pole of the needle. So finally, these two activities or experiments were there to prove that wherever the current is present, there is a magnetic field also. The direction of this deviation of needle was given by Ampere's swimming rule. And according to this rule, let me read out the statement of this rule. You will get the same concept which we have discussed in this activity. If a man is swimming along the wire in the direction of his face always turns towards the needle, so that the current enters through his feet and leaves at his head, then the north pole of magnetic needle will be deflected towards his left hand. Now apply this one here. Suppose a man is swimming in this direction and current is entering through his feet to his head. That current is leaving at his head. This is the condition. Man is swimming in such a way that he, the current, his direction, his face is always turned towards the needle. This is the face of needle and this is the face of man, the swimmer. Current enters through his feet and leaves at his head. The direction of flow of current is this one. So we are saying the person is also swimming in this direction. Then the north pole of magnetic needle deviated, yeah, deflected towards his left hand. If a person is swimming, these are his hands, right hand and left hand. So the needle was deflected towards his left hand. So this was the direction of the deflection or deviation of the needle given by Ampere's swimming rule. The direction of current was explained by the direction of swimming of a particular man. This rule can be learned by the keyword snow. When the current is flowing from south to north, this is south, this is north, the current is flowing in this direction. When the current is flowing from south to north in a wire which is over a magnetic needle, then the needle's north pole deflected towards the west. It deviated towards the west. So you can also learn the direction concept by this keyword snow. Current is flowing from south to north, then magnetic needle deflected towards the west. This is given by the Ampere's swimming rule also, and you can learn this concept by the keyword snow also. So this was the proof initially which was considered positively ki yes, current can also produce the magnetic effect. okay, magnetic field. In our previous chapters, first three chapters completely we have done. There we discussed that a charge, whether it is at rest or it is moving, it is a source of electric field. Okay, the same charge, if it is moving, means it is constituting some current, then it is a source of both electric plus magnetic field. If a charge is at rest, stationary charge is a source of electric field, but a moving charge is a source of both electric as well as magnetic field. A moving charge is a source of both, because moving charge means current is there, and magnetic effect of current you have observed, you have learned through this activity given by the Orestian. Like electric field, magnetic field is also a vector quantity. Like electric field, magnetic field is also a vector quantity. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the things which are related to current. They are producing some magnetic field, and we are going to find out the magnitude of magnetic field, the direction of magnetic field. Magnetic field due to a wire, magnetic field due to a coil, ampere circuit law, Baird separate law. In electrostatic, we discussed Coulomb's law. Similarly, here we discuss Baird separate law. Okay, with the help of which we are going to find out the value of magnetic field due to various objects. A current carrying wire, a current carrying coil, but current's presence is necessary. Because here we are not discussing the magnetism due to a magnet. We are discussing magnetism due to moving charges, or you can say current. So current is necessary there. Okay, in next chapter, in chapter 5th, we are going to discuss the magnetism, the natural magnetism due to the magnets. That thing we will discuss later. Recently we finished the unit current electricity. So we are going to discuss magnetic field due to the current, or magnetic effect of the current. In our next class, we are going to discuss about the magnetic Lorentz force. In a magnetic field, if a charged particle is moving, how much force it is experiencing? This thing we are going to discuss in our next class. So we continue for the next class. Thank you. This is sufficient for this one.